This week I've got The Predator, which is an interesting one for me. I enjoyed Predator, the very original film. I'm not one of those people who like worships the film, you know, in terms of the kind of Alien versus Predator universe. Actually, I probably enjoy Alien films more, but I definitely like Predator. I was excited for this film. I haven't seen a ton of the other sequels, so it's good because like your knowledge base of Predator and the Predator universe doesn't have to be that extensive to enjoy this movie. Well, enjoy might be a relative term, but you don't have to be like a Predator super fan. There are definitely references that are fantastic if you do get them because of it. But generally, the premise is hunter aliens drop to Earth. Okay, great. It stars Olivia Munn, Boyd Holbrook, Trevante Rhodes from Moonlight, Jacob Tremblay from Room, Keegan-Michael Key, Sterling K. Brown from This Is Us, Alfie Allen from Game of Thrones, Jake Busey, which is a fun little cameo in there, Yvonne Strahovski, and Thomas Jane, which I was like, what the heck is Thomas Jane doing here? Like, it was just a very surprising casting choice. He was fine in it. A couple casting things. First of all, love Olivia Munn. Love her to bits. Just nothing bad to say about her there. Boyd Holbrook, I have an interesting... I'm not the biggest Boyd Holbrook fan. I didn't love him in Logan. I thought his performance was incredibly like weird, over the top, and at the same time wooden, which I didn't think was possible. He's pretty good in Narcos, of course, but this one I found him like temperately watchable. The rest of the supporting cast is pretty good. Jacob Tremblay is a little kid and has a great acting future ahead of him. I feel like he may have been in a different movie in this. One of the things I will note is that he plays a character with autism, which whenever I see roles like that, I'm like, okay, like he handled it seemingly delicately, but could we have maybe found an actor with autism? Like, could we give more chances to actors with, you know, various sets of abilities? It's just one of those things that you think about when you watch one of these movies. There is actually a moment in particular that pissed me off. I'm just going to flat out say it, and it's going to be a spoiler for one line in the film. So if you're one of those people who cares that much, they throw around the word retarded, and I'm like, it's 2018. Can we like not? And it's not even in an enlightened way. And yes, I know somebody's going to call me a social justice warrior for pointing this out, but like, come on, like don't. It's just not. You can write better than that. You can be a better writer than that. Even if you're Shane Black, who already has his problems, director Shane Black. If you have followed or if you haven't followed the controversy, you know he's a. I enjoyed the film for the most part, but there are moments where I'm like, it's tough to get over these parts. And also, the decision to cast a friend of his, who is a convicted sex offender in the movie, without informing the cast or the studio, and then Olivia Munn had to have a scene with him and was like, what the hell? So they cut the scene, but like, what? Shane Black, poor choices all around. The other interesting or bizarre choice was to have Sterling K. Brown play this batshit crazy military man researcher dude who I think is playing very much against the type that people are used to seeing him on This Is Us. I don't actually watch This Is Us, but my understanding of the show is it's a much more wholesome family thing than, of course, you know, a Predator film is going to be. So the movie is not great. I will give it that. It is not a great movie. I objectively understand that. The pacing can be a little off. There are some scenes that like go a little too far in terms of like they should have cut off and been edited out like a little bit earlier in the beat. Some of the CG is terrible. I'm like, there's one scene where there's one scene where a predator drops in and it's just like, this looks like it's not done yet. Like, this looks like I'm seeing like an in-progress version of this. And I was like, oh my God, this is final. Holy crap. That being said, watching the whole movie, like, I didn't feel the need to, I talk about this a lot, like, check the clock for how much time is left. I didn't feel the need to, like, get up and leave. So I enjoyed it. It's very bloody. It's very violent. There's some weird humor in it, except for the few lines that I've already talked about. Like, it's more or less fine. But yeah, it's... The more I talk about it, the more I'm like, was it? But no, it's during the experience, during watching through, I had a fine, enjoyable time, you know, didn't have a bad time. It was like, whatever, this is not going to be a classic. This is not going to like reboot the Predator series and be a majestic, legendary entry into this series. But it's a good Predator movie about aliens, like hunting things and ripping people apart and people ripping aliens apart. And, you know, why not? If that's what you're into, I think you'll be fine with this movie. I'm only going to give it 2.5 out of 5, but it's fine. I think actually if this had not been a Predator film and if this had, you know, it was just like the premise was these random aliens land on Earth and are here to kill people, I think it would have been a better film. Like, I think with the attachment to that existing franchise, like, people have expectations and it's not going to meet certain of those. But 2.5 out of 5, not bad. It's not bad. I know a lot of people like hate it a lot more, but whatever. Get over it. It's The Predator. You'll be fine. The other film I have this week is a simple favorite, and this one was a big surprise for me. I thought it was going to be terrible. Like, I thought this was going to be awful, and I'd leave. It's directed by Paul Feig. It stars Anna Kendrick and Blake Lively, and of course, my boy Henry Golding. Paul Feig is, of course, typically known for his comedies, and so this was like, oh, this is going to be interesting. And basically, Anna Kendrick stars as this crazy mom vlogger who's a single mom. Blake Lively is basically Blake Lively, I assume. She's, you know, some iteration of Blake Lively. She's a head of PR for some fancy fashion firm in New York, and they always refer to the city and this and that, and it's very silly. But she's like, you know, she wears crazy lady suits, like female cut suits that are only probably somebody with Blake Lively's body could pull off. Good for her. Henry Golding plays Blake Lively's husband. I think one of my notes is, why is Blake Lively always dressed as a magician in this? But basically, they form a very quick friendship, and then things go wrong, and Blake Lively's character goes missing. And so Anna Kendrick takes it upon herself to try and find her. And I give this movie a lot of credit. They did a lot of things, I would say, right. The first half of this movie, I think, is really good. It's suspenseful. You don't know where it's going to go for the first half. And the thing about the second half is that's the same case, but even in a less comprehensible way. It's just such a point that you're just like, I think I give up. So, you know, it's a mystery. It's a mystery to the very end. So there's a lot of twists and turns and like who's lying to who and who's really what they mean and all that fun sort of jazz. And I'm not going to spoil it because I mean... it was a surprise to me, but only because it was so incomprehensible as a moviegoer that, like, normally I'm pretty good about picking out, like, here's the twist, here's the turn. But I was like, okay, this is, yep, some things are happening. I hope this does not ruin it for people as it does for me, but the whole movie feels like a giant aviation gin commercial. And for those who don't know, aviation gin is a gin company owned by Blake Lively's husband, or with a stake in it by Blake Lively's husband, my boy Ryan Reynolds. And so they keep drinking and cutting to shots of aviation gin. And I was just like, did aviation gin pay for this movie? There are a lot of kind of cliche things that it leans on that I kind of wish it had been more creative than. There are moments that I thought were great. All the stuff with the mommy vlogging, I think, is dead on. You know, there's the comedy stuff. There's a lot of quick banter. And I think Paul Feig does that really well. And, you know, the script is by Jessica Sharzer and Darcy Bell. And I thought it was except for that second half, pretty tight script. And at least in terms of dialogue, it's a tight script. Yeah, again, I'm looking over my notes and the second half is almost incomprehensible, but I still had an enjoyable time watching it. So I guess both Predator and A Simple Favor, it's like I had a good time watching it. So, you know, or at least I had a better time watching A Simple Favor. I laughed a lot more, actually. Not that I'm supposed to laugh at Predator, so it's fine. I think Simple Favor is worth checking out. I'm going to give it 3.7 out of 5.